Welcome to my new video. In this video I will explain the cast function in LINQ queries. How to use it. You will learn how to loop through rows and columns of data table using LINQ query. Let's start. I have here a table in Excel, which consists of 10 columns and 1 row. I want to loop through the columns and rows. We have to check if the first row contains the text A4. If the row contains this text, I want to get the column name. In this example we should get the following column names as result, because these columns contains the text A4 in the first row. To do that, we need to use the function cast. Before start writing the LINQ query, I will explain first the cast function and what we can do with it. Cast function used to convert an IEnumerable variable to a certain variable type of IEnumerable. For example, to convert to string, data row, data column, etc. What does that mean? IEnumerable variable in LINQ query is always from type object. But sometimes we need it as certain type of IEnumerable. For example, if we use the cast function to convert to string, the variable will be converted into type, system.string. The same also for data row or data column. We can convert to each type using this function. You will understand it better later, no worries. Just let me tell you first, how is the structure of cast function? For example, I want to go through columns of data table. The structure of cast function is the following. Data table variable, then the function columns, then the function cast, then of, then the new type what I need. For example, I have the following from statement. I define first a variable call for the columns, then I set the data table variable with its columns, then the cast function to convert the call variable to type, data column. What does that mean? If we have only this part, then is call variable of type object. But using cast function is the variable call now of type data column. This means, I can get all properties of data column type now. This was only introduction. Let's switch to UiPath to implement the query there. I have here the table in Excel. Table is in sheet 1. As you can see, we have the text A4 in the following columns. I want to get these columns as output and write them in a new sheet in Excel. First copy the Excel path to use it in UiPath later. Add read range activity to read the table from Excel. Add the path here. Remove the range to read the entire sheet. Create a variable for the table. Add build data table activity for the output table. Create an output variable. So we need only these two variables. Both are from type data table. As I mentioned before, we only need to get the column names. Therefore, I will create only one column in the output table. Add assign activity to write the query. Let's write the query now. Now I will explain the query. First I defined a variable for the columns and converted the type to data column. Then I added a new loop for the rows using a new variable. After that I set a condition to check the content of each row, if it's equal to A4. After that I selected the column name of each column, which meets the condition. This will be added to the output table. At the end I converted the output to data table. Now add write range activity to write the table in Excel. Enter the Excel path here. Change the sheet name. Add the output variable. Check Add Headers option to add the column names of the table in Excel. Now the code is ready and can be executed. As you can see, we have a new sheet. We have the output table here. We have first the column header of the output table. And the column names from the input table, where the content is A4. This result is the same as I mentioned at the beginning of the video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you like my videos.